Ladies and gents, welcome to the show. If you ain't into poetry, I think it's time to go. We got a lot of lyrics that you see on the show. Whenever they get finished, you gon' be wanting some more. Come over here and peep some of this poetry. Blowing with my lyrics, yeah, that's the meaning of poetry. I really like rhyming, that's your only way of knowing me. Tell your friends and family to come watch some NeoSoul. Ladies and gents, welcome to the show.
NeoSoul.
If you ain't into poetry, I think it's time to go.
NeoSoul.
We got a lot of lyrics that you see on the show.
NeoSoul.
Whenever they get finished, you gon' be wanting some love.
This is how we do it.
This is how we do it.
At Banneker High, and I feel alright. With education soaring on the south side, I walk in the class and the beats could be earned. Teachers serving knowledge and we're ready to learn. Hit the books class in session. Homies next to me as you're ready for this lesson. It feels so good, cause my test scores are high. As the listener skills, the living is sky. 5 and 7 left. The parents about to cry. At BHS, a good foundation has been laid. So we boldly strut and we throw our hands up. Success is here to stay. We're high above and it's all because
this is how we do it.
South Fulton does it like nobody does.
This is how we do it.
To all my neighbors, we got much favor.
This is how we do it.
We're on the fast track to receive it. This is how we do it. Grab caps up in the air. Be fun from here to there. If you're a freshman, B, or wanna be senior, BHS has been good to me. Ever since I was a lowercase B, but now I'm a big B. I'm about to earn that money. Dollar bills, y'all. If you realize how far I've come, you would know that I tried my mind and it wasn't my luck when they at a time reached my goal. Now there it is, a grand new life is underway. So we boldly strut and we throw our hands up. Success is here to stay. We're high above and it's all because
this is how we do it.
South Fulton does it like nobody does.
This is how we do it.
To all my neighbors, we got much favor.
This is how we do it.
We're on the fast track for the speed back.
This is how we do it.
Check it out, it's K Major on the mic. I'ma tell you how we kick it at Banneker High. We got every J at NBA and all that above. We got AP Robotics, FBLA, and Pearls. Look, it's a lot to choose from, like finance department. I couldn't draw a character, but it taught me well and all that. And so from there, I wanted to be in honors class, but I was tripping late, I had to be on top of class. Shout out the host of BTTV and the step team.
This is how we do it.
SGAFCCLA and the drama team.
This is how we do it.
Can't nobody do it like we do it over here in South Fulton.
This is how we do it.
We'll put you to the test, so I hope that you're up to it.
This is how we do it.
From engineering to the yearbook, yeah, all that do it.
This is how we do it.
SADD and JROTC, look.
This is how we do it.
And we learning all over here on the South Side, baby.
This is how we do it.
In the chest, when your grades looking good, you might get it.
This is how we do it.
Shout out to all the scientists, healthcare, and nutritional.
This is how we do it.
If you study your man, you could be very beneficial.
This is how we do it.
Hi, my name is Zephaniah Jones, and I wrote a poem called Pill Popping. I hope you enjoy. Not really sure if I'll get in trouble explaining this, about my unreturning smile and never coming back bliss, but it's to the point that I get headaches. So much that I down my mother's pill shelf to get this higher relaxation I never get. It's not something I recommend or even enjoy, but without it, I feel like skin without alloy. You don't need it, but it's helpful when your skin's dry. But you know, every time I take them, I don't wanna cry. I don't wanna scream, I don't wanna fight, cause I ain't afraid of people lying to me all night. I don't have those fears of people hating me. Even when you don't, you see, I fear every day that people don't love me, but they're out to get me. Call me crazy, but I ain't stupid, I'm just cautious. I'm preventing a relapse of last year, but no matter how much I do, my due date gets closer, I fear. That people really do love me the way that they say they do, how they don't wanna hurt me, but help me, cause they can see what my mind is doing to my body is cruel. I don't even think you wanna hear me speak. It's paranoia, not insecurities. I overthink to the point of overloading, after overloading my emotions, exploding. Ho, dirty, dumbass. It's all they think of me. They call themselves touching on me because they hear I'm easy. But I'm not, I'll never be. No matter who has something different to say, I know someday some luck will come my way. They spread rumors around saying I'm a tramp, saying that I effed up and every guy around the campus, trying and praying to break me. My friends turn faces due to their synthetic nature and strong hate for me. I'm sometimes always suicidal. That's why I used to pop open the prescription and down with the bottle. I have scars on my arms because I was so torn, because that loud voice inside of me wanted to be heard, but he got quieter every time I got something from a little bird. There's a mental noose around my neck. Every time I lose my step, it tightens, breaking off my breath. I fear me. Every morning I wake up, I ask me, will today be the day I do my enemies a favor and kill me? I never get the answer that I want, but more heartbreak, but more heartache and dumb trying to get some, not expecting the fact of my sexuality, but they go ahead and already mentally undress me. I want to put scars on my face to help erase the beauty inside me pouring out upon my face. I'm sick of the sick. They say how they want to lay me down and help them relax from a hard day. How they want to cover my face with, rip out my dress I own. They stare without a doubt. And when I tell them not to look, they tell me I want them to. So when I cover myself up, they ask me, where did my boobie or booties go? Now, when I look into the mirror, I don't see what Olivia sees. I don't see what Lonnie sees. I don't see what my mother sees, because the greedy bastards took that away from me. So now, when I see them, I'll ask or scream, where did you put my inner beauty? That's the mother who stole my beauty away from me.
Wow, Z's poem was very real and authentic, and it really makes you think, wow, there's really people who go through stuff out here. What do you think?
I loved her poem. I love how real and authentic you were. You go, Z. Can't nobody steal your beauty.
Yes. So now we're going to take you to an interview with Mr. Tyler Lepley of the Have and the Have Nots, followed by Miss Z herself here joining us with her interview.
My interview hat off, I'm going to give it to you. Here we go. Let's do it.
So what does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
For me, it means being able to overcome any type of obstacles or boundaries or hurdles that stand in your way in order to get or claim whatever you feel you deserve or whatever you want. And that's what we're all celebrating here.
All right, thank you. Would you mind doing a quick drop real quick?
Of course, yeah. Who we dropping? Who we shouting out?
Neo Soul.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Tyler Lepley. I'm chilling with my man right here. Check out Neo Soul.
Thank you.
Sure, I appreciate it, man.
Hi, I'm Eric Ward with NeoSoulTV.
Yes, sir.
And so, what does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
It means everything, you know, to honor people who've contributed to the community, who've done so many things, whether it be financial or just mentoring. It's an honor to be here. It's a first-class award show, and I'm happy to be a part of it this year.
Great. What is your biggest accomplishment?
My biggest accomplishment would probably Just being able to do something that inspire people. You know, I'm a professional singer. I sing gospel music. So I sing songs that inspire and uplift people and kind of take their mind off of their situations and their storms sometimes. And I get a chance to sing positive music that can change their outlook on their situation. So that's huge for me. Hi, I'm Isaac Curry, and you're watching Neo Soul TV.
And we're back with the Miss Zephaniah Jones in person herself.
Welcome, Z. I'm glad to have you here.
So, Z, the name of your poem was Pill Popping. So, did you ever really pop pills?
Yeah. My mom had a medicine case full of medication, full of, like, codeine or muscle relaxers and, you know, anything that I can get my hands on. And I would always take either half of it or the whole pill, you know, if I was going through a bad day and just down that with alcohol.
And I noticed you said, like, the first line in your poem said, I might get in trouble. And I feel like a lot of people don't talk about what's going on because they feel that they would get bullied even more, or that their mom, like you said, if she saw this, she'll probably kill you. But I feel like they don't come out with it because they're too scared. And I feel like Yuzi, you came out with that, and you can inspire a whole lot of people just with this poem.
I mean, with me, I kind of really don't give a F, you know what I mean? It's true though, like, I don't care. And because I don't care, I do a lot of things that I put my mind to. And people either, you know, inspire me about that, or they either get upset with me about that. Yeah.
I mean, well, we're not born in this world to please everybody else. Yes. If it feels good to you, do it. If it don't do it.
Yeah. So since you wrote the poem, has everything been better for you now?
No. I'm just playing. It has been, because I don't cut anymore. I'm not really suicidal anymore.
That's wonderful.
Basically, ever since that I wrote that poem, I've really like looked up, because I just stopped it with negativity, basically.
Exactly. So poetry helped your outlet. Mm-hmm. So all you gotta do really is find an outlet and do it. I encourage the arts. A lot of my family, they're artists. They do that to outlet all their troubles. So, I mean, find you and do it.
Yes.
That's my last comment.
So we wanna thank you for joining us today.
Can you ask some last words?
Thank you.
Is there anything that you would like to say to the viewers at home?
Oh, glad you asked. with me, all I have to say is, if you got something on your mind and it's tearing you apart, put it down on paper and share it with the closest person that you can. Even if it's an audience, do it, because you don't know how much it could save your life.
Well, thank you, Miss Z.
I love you, Z.
Hi, I'm Nino Coral, here for BTTV News, and we're on the red carpet at the Trumpet Awards. What the Trumpet Awards means to us, obviously Black achievement, and I can't believe that we're here and honored to meet some of the people that are the honorees of the Trumpet Award, and some people who are guests and family. You never know who you'll see on the red carpet, so stay tuned.
Thank you for inviting
me. Hi. I'm a huge fan.
Homecoming King?
Yes.
Come court.
Yes, I was Mr. Drama Club.
Mr. Drama, oh, now you full of drama.
No.
Okay,
I'm a huge fan. I love R&B Divas LA.
Do you?
Yes.
Thank you.
So I wanted to know, what does the Trumpet Awards mean?
It means our people honoring our people with excellence.
Right. Can I get you to sing a quick job for, if you don't mind, for Neo Soul?
Neo Soul. God did that. You see how?
Thank you.
I didn't say that.
Thank you.
Can you tell us what the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
You know what? Any chance or opportunity we have to honor people in our community who are doing great things, not just for themselves, but for other people, it's fantastic. And that's what the Trumpet Awards really means to me. It's a huge version of community service. And I think really that's what we're all put on the earth to do, is provide service for other people. And the Trumpet Awards symbolizes that. So I'm really excited.
Do you have any special talents that the people may not know about you?
Special talents? You know what? Yeah. I refinish furniture in my spare time. So I will take a piece from the flea market or something, you know, that, that maybe a crackhead household sale on the side of the street, and I will buy it for $20 and make it look like it cost $1 million. That's probably my biggest talent, is kind of decorating.
Well, you look very beautiful.
Oh, I appreciate that.
What are you wearing?
Now that's a shame. That is such a shame. But my stylist is Yurita Sanchez, and she got the dress and the shoes for me. I know what I'm wearing on my shoes because my feet, because they hurt. They're red bottoms, you know. Don't believe the hype about the red bottoms. They absolutely hurt your feet. It is not healthy for us ladies. Let it go. Let it go.
Absolutely.
So what does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
That's the question of the day, right? Everyone's been asking that. Well, for me, I've been to the Trumpet Awards for several years, so this is my first time as a presenter, so I am astounded and honored that they asked me to be a part this year, but it's a legacy. It really is. This is part of our culture, our heritage. You know, we can go back decades and talk about the people who've paved the way and been trailblazers, but this award, what makes it special is not just how many albums you've sold or how many Instagram followers you have, but it's what you mean to our people and what you've managed to instill in our community. And so that's why I love the Trumpet Awards.
Well, you look stunning. What are you wearing?
I'm wearing Giovanni.
Okay.
Thank you. Hello. How are you, Diva?
Good. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Cache Winston, a.k.a. Cache the Talented. And I'm going to share with you two poems, one called You Want to Be Successful and two called I Don't Like You. All right. You want the money, money in the cars, cars in the clothes. I suppose you just want to be successful. I just want to be successful. Some people get in the game for the money and the fame and lose control when they've seen what they became, playing big shop and never pay their dues and always being the main topic in the news. No clues, just fools disrespecting my industry, my love, my heart, my hobby, my start. You see, just wait, I'll be a nominee, reinforcing what black entertainment used to be. You see, this is art. More than a TV show or a commercial, more than a play with a quick rehearsal, more than nail art, more than paintings, more than video games and hairstyle maintainings. Art is everything. Art is life. But of course, you wouldn't know because you're so focused on the money, money in the cars, cars in the clothes. I suppose you just want to be successful. I just want to be successful. Success is the height to the never-ending goal. Miss Winston myself once said acting comes from the soul. Music from the lips, dance from the hips, but you're too high on studio drugs and reality show love to notice it. Becoming one-hit wonders because you played the industry like a joke. And your failure is life-threatening like a stroke because you never finished school. And you never knew what art was. Probably from the start, it wasn't in your heart because you were too focused on the money. Money in the cars, cars in the clothes. I suppose you just want to be successful. I just want to be successful. That's it. Okay, so the second poem I got is a poem that I wrote when I was 14 years old, I want to say, and I know this is kind of not with you, probably like a 14-year-old thinking about that. Oh, I'm very mature. So here it is. I like you, but I don't, and I won't tell you how I feel because didn't I just say I don't like you? Maybe if we were close like the most, but you said that's gross, so I separated myself, departing me from you and the stuff you took me through. Closing doors, we open together, locking up forever, so you think you're so clever, but you're not. I see through you like crystal rock. I say you cannot hide. I say we bonded like negative and positive charges coming together, creating a spark. You comforted me in the dark, then broke my heart from part to part. You ripped and clawed and cut and sawed. From artery to artery, we ought to be tired, but we continue to make up and break up. You take up my time. I should be through with this rhyme. But I'll continue. That's it.
Hey,
y'all. That was my girl Cachet, a.k.a. Cachet the Talented. Yeah. And we're going to take you to another interview from the Trumpet Awards, and we're going to bring her out in just a quick second.
Hi, I'm Eric Ward, and I'm from Banneker High School, and I'm repping NeoSoulTV here at the Trumpet Awards. We are looking forward to seeing so many people today, and it has been so wonderful, just the journey. So stay tuned. What does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
The Trumpet Awards means a lot to me. You know, I grew up on it, and it's exciting to see the black community coming together. Not even the black community, but everybody coming together. The performances, the honorees, everything. It's just amazing.
All right, can you do a quick drop for Neo Soul?
Yes. What's up, everybody? It's Tiana Crawley, Season 2 Sunday Best Winner, and I am with Neo Soul.
Hi. Can you tell us what the Trumpet Awards means to you?
What it means to me, the Trumpet Awards. I'm here because I know what they represent, recognizing those that, you know, give back. So that's why I'm here. Because I'm definitely one that likes to give back and get more involved, you know?
Hi.
So what does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
Well, I mean, they're awarding and recognizing black excellence, and I think that, especially lately with all the things that we see in the news, it seems like it's always when you see someone that's African American, they always want to highlight the negative, and we need to highlight the positive. If they're not going to do it, mainstream media, then we need to do it for ourselves. So, you know, that's definitely something that makes me smile and glad to be here.
All right. What's one piece of advice that you would give to people at home?
Don't take no for an answer. If it's something that you really believe in, then you should really, you know, put 110% into it. You know, and ignore the naysayers. I block negativity every single day out of my life, and I refuse to accept people being negative in my life, so.
Even Sass, what does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
Well, it means a lot. I'm here to celebrate, along with all the honorees, you know, the people that have contributed so much to our community. And tonight I'm singing a song to Tommy Hilfiger. It's a song called Time After Time, and it's just, you know, a great moment. This is my first time actually attending, so I'm very, very excited about tonight.
That's great. What are you wearing?
I'm wearing Roberto Cavalli.
Would you mind doing a pub for Neo Soul?
Sure.
You're watching Neo Soul? You can even sing it if you like.
Okay. Hey, this is Deborah Cox and you're watching Neo Soul. Woo.
So who are you looking forward to seeing tonight?
Why, man, I'm looking forward to seeing everybody. You know, why we got to pick favorites? Why do we have to pick favorites? Everybody's my favorite, so I'm looking forward to seeing a lot of people. I've already seen a lot of great people. It's going to be a good night. Yeah.
Can you tell us what the Trumpet Awards means to you?
Well, the Trumpet Awards mean to me is to celebrate those who have made such a great impact in the community, and not just only, but great humanitarians and those who have really, really helped a lot of people in the world today. So we're really, really just happy to be here.
So who are you looking forward to most tonight?
I'm just looking forward to seeing all the honorees tonight, actually. I'm excited to be a part of the whole show and just be present. It's a blessing and an honor.
All right. So what does the Trumpet Awards mean to you?
The Trumpet Awards, to me, is a great opportunity for people in our community to be honored for all their courageous acts as well as their commendable acts in the community. I just think it's a time for us to encourage and continue to uplift each other and give recognition where recognition is due.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Jasmine Burke, and you are watching Neo Soul TV.
By the way, can you tell us what you're wearing?
Yes, I am wearing custom House of Balenciaga, styled by Julian Lark.
You look beautiful.
Thank you so much. Thank
you. And we're back with the Miss.
And we're
Cachet
back
the
with
tap.
The Miss.
Cachet the Tap. What's up?
Cachet. What's up?
The voice reminds me of Kiki Palmer.
Gabrielle.
So let's start with your first
success poem.
Success.
That poem gave me so much
that
life.
That poem gave me
it's
so
like,
much life.
You're talking
it's
to
like
everyone in
you're
the
talking
industry.
To everyone
so,
in the industry.
To you,
so,
what does poetry mean?
To
or
you,
just
what
your works
poetry.
At all, or just your works
to me,
at all.
Poetry is all about
to me,
expression.
Poetry is all
expressing
about expressing yourself through words.
Expressing yourself
the way
through
you
words.
Wanna.
Express
the way
yourself.
You wanna.
Not
the way
yourself.
Anybody else. What comes
not
from
the way
your
anybody
heart.
Else.
What comes from your heart.
That's poetry.
Yourself.
That's poetry.
My heart.
My soul on paper. My soul.
And I noticed you said. And I noticed that you said
scared to finish school.
That you scared to finish school.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Explain that. Oh, okay. So explain that. Oh,
basically,
okay, so
that part.
Basically, that part
was
basically
that's basically
with all my rappers out there. Not most of rappers out there.
Not most of them, but a good handful of rappers that
one-hit wonders.
Become one-hit wonders.
And when they do,
and this doesn't just happen in
rapping. They never finish school.
They never finish school.
As soon as they get that first
taste
discovery.
Yeah,
it's all of money.
I want to be successful.
You know,
I want to be successful.
So what I wrote that about was they never finish school, so they feel you know, like they're dropping out of school, and we already have a statistic, so it's important that you sit there and finish that they should graduate, still pursue what they're doing just as you are doing.
I feel like you should always pursue success. It means you're gonna fall down, you're gonna scrape, you need to fall down, you're gonna scrape, it's just how you get up and take that.
Any last words, Cachet?
Any last words, Cachet?
I just want to say, follow your dreams. All things are possible through Christ. All things are possible. God is a godly woman.
I just want to say thank you for the opportunity, guys. Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for coming.
So when we get back, you will see the stylings, the music, the lyrics of Miss K Major.
Ladies and gents, welcome to the show. If you ain't in the poetry, I think it's time to go. We got a lot of lyrics that you see on the show. Whenever they get finished, you gon' be wanting some more. Come over here and peep some of this poetry. Blowing with my lyrics, yeah, that's the meaning of poetry. I really like rhyming, that's your only way of knowing me. Tell your friends and family to come watch some Neo Soul. Ladies and gents, welcome to the show. Neo Soul. If you ain't into poetry, I think it's time to go. Neo Soul. We got a lot of lyrics that you see on the show. Neo Soul. Whenever they get finished, you gon' be wanting some love.
This is how we do it.
We'll put you to the test, so I hope that you're up to it.
This is how we do it.